Hello guys, so today we are going to be finding Renee and asking her a few questions. Kind of cool that we go to the same school right now. So yeah, just waiting for her to show up. I'll be here in about a few minutes. So for now, you're just going to have to chill out and relax with me. So yeah. Ah, there she is. Look.
Hey Joe, what's up?
Not much. How are you doing?
Good. How's your day?
Pretty good. Glad classes are over.
Really?
So hey, if you don't mind, I'm going to ask you a few questions
yeah?
while you take a walk. Yeah.
Okay, that'd be awesome.
All right, so
okay.
Just out of curiosity, I'm about almost 6'1". How tall are you?
I am, is there any chalk to measure how high I am? But no, I'm like 5'8". Really, that's okay.
Okay, now what do you think when you meet someone new?
When I meet someone new?
Yeah.
That's a good question. Like, when I meet somebody new, I'm usually thinking more about myself at first than them. Like, I kind of wish I was more sympathetic towards people when I first meet them, because I'm already so self-conscious about myself. I need to work on that, actually. Something I need to work on. So I want to be, like, really excited to meet people, because I actually really am. In fact, I'm so excited to meet them. I'm hoping they will like me, too, because I already like them.
Well then.
Yeah, so I'm getting kind of thirsty. We should go for a walk.
Okay, yeah, sure. Let's do that. So, what is something you think about every single day?
Something I think about every single day is how I really want to, like, know what people are really, really thinking
mm-hmm.
all the time. Like, what are you actually thinking? Because I actually think a lot of things that I never, ever say. So, like, I really want to know people genuinely, I guess. So I think about that every day when I'm with people. Wonder how they're actually doing.
Mm-hmm. Cool. Actually, if you ever want to know what I'm thinking, every now and then I just think it's awesome how your favorite color is red.
Yeah, my favorite color is red. In fact, my bedspread is red too. It's definitely my favorite color. It has been since preschool. It was blue for a little while. Now it's back to red again.
Ah, gotcha.
Because it looks like the votive candles, and I think those look so pretty.
Yeah. So just, yeah. Okay, so next question. What is something you wish would improve in the world?
Something I wish would improve in the world? That would definitely have to be something along the lines of true love, I feel like, is corrupted in the world, not just between like couples, but between like friends. And I feel like there's so many restrictions of what you can, can't say, or else it's too intimate or something of that sort. And I just think it's like, because love's been corrupted by lust so much in our society, and
mm-hmm.
so that's what I wish I could fix, is like increase like real love in just regular friendships without it being corrupted by like lust and other things like that.
That's really awesome. Alright, so we're back. Next question. What's something that happens to you, something strange that happens to you because of your YouTube channel?
Something strange. Oh, wow. Sometimes I get these little smiles from people in public here at school, and, like, I don't know them. And I'll get other people that are like, you look really familiar. I'm like, I do, because I have never seen you in my life.
Yeah, yeah.
I, like, feel really bad, because maybe I actually did meet them. But there's always, like, this thought in the back of my head, like, maybe have you watched YouTube videos before, and things like that.
I had the same thing happen one time, of like, last semester. So he's like, I think I know you. And then
yeah.
I was just like, yeah, you probably do. But, all right, next question, still on YouTube. How do you deal with YouTube comments?
I usually, at this point, I don't really answer them as often. I used to answer them a lot when my channel was smaller because, I mean, in order for it to keep growing, you have to kind of, like, keep up with your audience when it's small, so you build it up. But now it seems like the audience just answers their own questions, and so I don't really have to do any apologetic answers very often.
Mm-hmm.
But I will, like, tell people to send me their stories and insights, and I read everything that's sent to me, every comment, I read it. So I encourage people to send me stuff, because I will still read it and say, like, wow, and sometimes my responses are kind of short, but that's okay, right?
Because
I still read it.
Right.
It gets kind of crazy sometimes.
Right, yeah, totally. I mean, to be honest, I think you're doing better than I am, because I try to look at all my comments, but I just can't. What is the best thing someone can say to you?
Something that I'd really like to hear, something like that.
Yeah.
Well, you know the, like, the love languages? People are like, oh, touch, oh,
right, 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 right,
oh,
right.
Like, Words of affirmation. I think I'm words of affirmation, honestly. So YouTube comments really do like mean a lot to me when people mm-hmm. say like that I've helped them or they really like to sort of insight on something.
Right. I personally, yeah, it's always great when people just say how much they appreciate whatever it is you're doing.
Is it too dark in here?
I think so, yeah.
Let's go outside.
Yeah.
So this one girl said to me once, like, I feel really like, peaceful around you. And I was like, wow.
Yeah, yeah.
That's so nice.
That's so great.
Especially, like, after confession and stuff, I do feel very peaceful. Mm-hmm. Like, if I'm in a group where I'm praying my rosary every day, I feel really peaceful. And I guess that actually, like, exudes out. So mm-hmm. it's, like, a really thing to keep up with.
Right, yeah. When you get graces, it's our job to spread them to other people. And then their job to spread them to us. So,
yeah.
There you go.
Exactly.
All right, now switching tones a little bit, what's something that makes you sad?
Something that makes me sad. Something that makes me sad is when people... Let's see.
Just such a happy person.
I'm just such a happy person. I guess the thing that makes me sad is when people put off opportunities of getting to know other people. I see many people just walk right by. They don't say hi back when you say hi to them. Mm-hmm. Or they... you try to be their friend, but then one person isn't really trying. And I'm just like, you're missing out on an opportunity to really like get to know a person, which is an amazing thing, amazing opportunity that so many people wish they had mm-hmm. to have like a really good friend.
Yeah. You know? Friends are awesome, and it's hard to understand what we do without them sometimes.
Yeah.
Something simple that makes you happier.
Happier. Oh.
Because you're already a happy person, so happier.
Hi, Helen. Seeing Helen in the hallways makes me happier. It's very simple. When people, yeah, smile at me for sure. When I get random hugs from people, it makes me really happy. Hi, Helen. This is my friend Helen. She works in the
drama.
I'm allergic to that, but thank you for offering.
See, random hugs.
Yeah, and when people are generous and just offer me things, it's so nice.
All right. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
I just really wanted to ruin that shot.
Oh, and by the way, we're going to need like some people from the drama department to help us out with videos because we're doing a lot more and we need some good actors and actresses. So, yeah, keep that in mind.
Yeah, I'm sure. Do you have our emails? I can give you our contact.
I will Facebook you and we will get that all right. Yeah, we'll get it all organized. Thanks, Helen. Bye.
Got your back, girl.
Yeah. See, that these people make me happy.
And speaking of hugs, to be honest, totally agree with that. I'm literally always up for a hug anytime. Now, how do you really view your work?
I view it as almost like a personal diary of my own faith life, and it's something I look back to for myself.
Actually, one time it was funny, a friend was asking me a certain question. I was just like, I forgot how I should exactly respond. Yeah. I watched one of my old videos and used an analogy from there, and they're like, oh, that helps so much. Like, I help myself, literally.
Yeah. Some people are asking the questions, and I'll be like, I have a video for that.
If you could vlog anywhere, where would that be?
I'd like to vlog in St. Peter's Square and like live a block from Rome and just like vlog around Rome about Catholicism every day.
This is why we are friends, because
yes.
I just want to go.
Or vlog here.
I just want to go to Rome, period. Oh my gosh, that looks awesome. What is one thing you wish people knew about you?
What is one thing I wish people knew about me? Hi, Rachel. Rachel's in here till 9, this poor dear. Here, show her in. How are you doing, Rachel?
What?
Hanging in there?
Yep.
Oh boy. We're doing a questionnaire thing. Joe's asking me some questions.
Yeah.
But what is one thing I wish people knew about me? Is that I will give you the benefit of the doubt on everything.
There you go.
The benefit of the doubt on everything. And I will try to see what the... I will try to see everything that is good about you. I specifically look for the good things about you. And I usually wish I could say way more than I actually say. I could write books on some of my friendships, and they have no idea that I could.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah. Sometimes I feel like a creep, but I honestly could say so much that I love about people and mm-hmm. how much I'll miss them and how much I appreciate them right now in my life.
Mm-hmm. Hey, what are some things you wish you were better at doing?
I could improve on my timeliness. I'm usually late for a lot of things. Let's see. I'd like to improve on I guess there's like the spiritual life ways you'd want to improve.
Mm-hmm.
Be a great example for my family in the future and now in the present time for the siblings that I have. I'm doing this for all the people that love me or show me any sort of like support. Like, this is the fruits of their support, is what I'm doing. I want to do that.
Support and their prayers, most importantly. Yeah. So yeah, that's kind of all the questions I have. Let's go brave the cold and see what adventures lie ahead.
It's cold. All right. The interview, Joe.
Yeah, sure thing.
All right. Good night, everyone. I'm gonna go back to my dorm and get some sleep.
Bye.
Bye.